Hey guys, Jasmine here coming at you with another episode of Golgotha. Today we are going to be talking about spirits. We're perfectly comfortable with bodies. We're perfectly comfortable with the concept of a soul. But spirits seem to be such a mystery to people.
What is it about?
And that is what we are going to tackle today.
Several of us have gotten locked in the lighthouse. We've had sightings of the shadow figure.
I heard a man running up the stairs.
Let's figure out what the heck's going on here.
Is someone in here with us?
Let's come closer.
Here to help you.
We're not looking for ghosts. We're looking for the truth.
The topic of ghosts has been around as long as there have been human beings. The definition of ghosts in the traditional belief of fiction is a specter, a phantom, or apparition of the soul or spirit of a dead person, invisible form, or other manifestation to the living. But what does the Bible have to say about ghosts?
The Bible teaches very clearly that there are indeed spirit beings who can connect with and appear in our physical world. But the Bible negates the idea that the spirits of deceased human beings can remain on earth and haunt the living. Demons are fallen angels, angels who rebelled against God. Demons are evil, deceptive, and destructive. According to 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 14 through 15, demons masquerade as angels of light and as servants of righteousness.
Typical classifications of the way in which the devil is going to work. Tentatio, infestatio, oppressio, obsessio. Temptation, infestation, oppression, and then possession, right?
Appearing as a ghost and impersonating a deceased human being definitely seems to be within the power and ability that demons possess.
If you can bring your attention to the top of your head like we've been doing.
I want to know how old you were. I feel like he was like a teenager. I feel bad for him.
What makes you feel bad?
Because he was so young.
Hello,
Tim.
Josh. Nice to meet you.
Tyler.
Hi. How are you doing?
What I feel like, if you talk to the kid downstairs, it might make him feel welcome. Because I think he's sad because every time they're down there, they come right back up because they're scared of him.
That makes sense.
Yes, very much.
I'm really proud of her. She's doing a great job.
There are still more beings in the spiritual realm, like the cherubim and also the angels.
So let's talk about them.
Well, the word angel itself means messenger. And that's what they're often doing in the Bible, is they're sending messages. The second thing that angels do is they sing praise. That's why we often talk about the choirs of angels singing glory to God in the highest, glory to God in heaven. They also just in general serve God. The guardian angels that are assigned to each one of us are serving God by bringing about God's will here on earth. They are his servants. That's what angels do. First of all, we know that angels are spiritual beings. They have no body, whereas humans have bodies and spirits. They're also created. So even though they were with us at creation, they are also created by God. In other words, they're not gods themselves. They're not always existing. They are eternal, but they were created by God. And the third thing, they have intelligence and will. That means that angels can think and act independently. They can choose to disobey God, for example, which is what Satan and his fallen angels did. They disobeyed God. They rejected God. That's why they became fallen angels.
Everyone born is a living soul housed in the flesh. And the earthly house of a man the body is made from the dust or earth. And once the body dies, it returns to dust or earth. And his or her spirit or soul is then released into the spirit realm. Psalms 146:4. When their spirit departs, they return to the ground.
We're not looking for ghosts. We're looking for the truth.
Well, you have to start on page one of the Bible, where the uncreated world is depicted as this dark, chaotic place. But then above the chaos, God's spirit is there, hovering, ready to bring about life and order and beauty.
Okay, but what is God's spirit?
Ruach can refer to a number of different things, but what they all have in common is energy.
The Holy Spirit.
We see God's Ruach giving special empowerment to people for specific tasks. The first person in the Bible this happens to is Joseph.
God's Spirit enables him to understand and interpret dreams.
And then it happens to this guy named Bezalel, and he's an artist.
God's Spirit empowers him with wisdom and skills. He's given creative genius to make beautiful things in the tabernacle.
And we also see God's Ruach empower a group of people called the prophets.
They're able to see what's happening in history from God's point of view.
Centuries pass, and we are introduced to Jesus. And at the beginning of his mission, there's this beautiful scene where Jesus is being baptized in the waters of the Jordan River.
Yeah, the sky opens up, and God's Spirit comes and rests on him like a bird.
This story is saying that God's Spirit is empowering Jesus. He heals people or forgives their sins. He's creating life where there once was death.
Now, Israel's religious leaders oppose Jesus, and they eventually have him killed.
The earliest disciples of Jesus, who saw him alive from the dead, said it was God's energizing spirit that raised Jesus. When Jesus appeared to his closest followers, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit."
And soon after that, the Spirit powerfully comes on all of his disciples.
So that they can become a part of this new creation and share the good news and learn how to live by the energy and influence of God's Spirit.
All right, guys, that is all I have for you today. Do not forget to like, share, subscribe. Let me know what you think in the comments. I can't wait to see where it takes us next time.
Told me make sure all my demons are gone, so I turned away from Satan like my blinkers were on. They look at me like I'm crazy, I don't think I belong. Don't pretend to be strong, I preach Christ in my songs. I'm just getting sick and tired of the fake in the world. I feel like I'm a hurl, feel the weight like a curl. Got the gospel, I'm loaded, lyrics not sugar coated, trying to show them what they do.